Dystonia, as the name suggests, is a problem with abnormal posture, in a sense, so that muscle activity is uncontrolled and pulls a part of the body into an abnormal posture. But it's always been recognised that people who have dystonia may also have tremor as well. So tremor is an oscillation of a body part. So amongst people with dystonia, it's common to find people who have dystonic posturing and tremor as well. And you can see that across all different causes of dystonia. So for example, a proportion of people, maybe 30-40% of people with cervical dystonia will additionally have some kind of tremor. That can sometimes be just when they're trying to look away from the abnormal posture, in which case they may get some jerking, or it may be a more constant tremor that's there all the time. Many people with generalized dystonia will also have tremor, for example, of the limbs affected by dystonia. So the limb is postured abnormally, but also often in particular positions it might shake. There's more of a difficult diagnostic situation where a person may have tremor, but no abnormal posturing, or at least abnormal posturing that's very evident, but will have the kind of tremor that you often see in people who have dystonia. And those types of tremor are often there in a particular position, and they may be rather jerky. As a group, those people are often labelled as having dystonic tremor. So dystonia and tremor are things that go together. Tremor is an important part of the disability generated by dystonia for a significant proportion of people who have dystonia. And so it's an important symptom to recognise as part of the dystonia and to recognise how to treat it. There is a common form of tremor called essential tremor, and that describes a condition which is typically running in families and may present sometimes at quite a young age, maybe early adult life, sometimes later on, maybe in people's 60s or 70s. And classic essential tremor is a small tremor of both hands, usually when the hands are doing something, so on posture or carrying things. That can be, in some situations, a bit difficult to tell apart from tremor that's happening with dystonia. And so there are many people who have dystonia and tremor who get labelled as having essential tremor, or even more complicated, they might be labelled as having dystonia and essential tremor. This is all something which is rather difficult diagnostically within neurology and is probably not so important. I think the critical thing is just to recognise that dystonia and tremor are conditions that go together and that the tremor is part of the dystonia for some people, and that needs to be treated alongside the abnormal posturing. In terms of treatments for tremor, there are some medications which are not generally used for treatment of dystonia, so the abnormal posturing, but which can be helpful for people who have tremor. So for example, propranolol or other beta blocker medications might be used for tremor. Benzodiazepine medications, for example, clonazepam, might be used for tremor. Sometimes treatments which are given for the dystonia itself can also help the tremor. So you see that with some medications which are given to treat the abnormal posturing, they also benefit on the tremor. And you can also sometimes see that in treatments such as botulinum toxin, given to treat cervical dystonia, but it also helps with people's head tremor. And you also see that with deep brain stimulation surgery for certain types of dystonia, where the deep brain stimulation surgery will help the abnormal postures, but it also reduces the tremor. Sometimes you can do botulinum toxin injections specifically for tremor. That's a complicated treatment and something which needs significant expertise to do, but it is sometimes possible to reduce dystonic tremor by using botulinum toxin injections injected into muscles, usually of the arm, which are causing the tremor. Much more successfully and more easily, botulinum toxin can be used as a usually very good treatment for head tremor happening in the context of dystonia, and there it's the mainstay of treatment. Essential tremor is a diagnosis which is very commonly given in neurological practice. to describe people who develop a postural arm tremor or an arm tremor during movement, where typically investigations such as a scan of the brain are completely normal. What's become clear over time is that that is a syndrome. So what that means is that there's multiple causes for having postural arm tremor. And it seems increasingly the case that perhaps many people who have a diagnosis of a central tremor actually have dystonia, which is manifesting predominantly as tremor. But then when you examine them, you can see other signs which show that they have dystonia as well, for example, abnormal posturing. Now, the reason why that's important is that there may be treatments which you wouldn't routinely give for people with a central tremor or a central tremor syndrome, as it's known now, but which you might give for people with dystonia. So for people with an essential tremor label, it would be, or diagnostic label, it would be reasonable to maybe get an assessment, thinking about the possibility of dystonia, about whether that's a more reasonable explanation for what is going on.